Hey everybody, welcome back to American Truck Simulator episode 3. I hope you guys are enjoying the series so far. I have not made one in a while. It was actually kind of funny, I just recorded a whole like 30 minute video for you guys to watch. I went to play it back and it only was running at 5 frames per second because I had the wrong settings. So that was pretty cool. Some, I guess, quote unquote rookie mistake. But here I am back again to record you guys another episode right after I got done recording another one. But we're going to be doing this haul. As you can see, I got the new Freightliner FLB cab over. Very nice truck. I did have a whole bunch of upgrades done to it, the twin stacks and everything. But we are already at our destination where we need to be to pick up this load. So we already told everybody that we were here, and let's go pick it up. First things first, we got to fire this truck up. Turn on the headlights, and now we can see the inside of the truck. As you can see, we got the bed back here. We got the Eaton Fuller 18-speed transmission CAT. I believe it's a C15 engine. I did put a new steering wheel in here. Got the CB radio, the police radar. We got it all. All right, so let's go pick this thing up. First, let me turn on the little cheap mirrors, I guess. Looks like we're going to be taking some fertilizer today. We're going to be going to about 33,000 pounds. We're going to El Centro, Sunshine Crops. We're expected to be there Friday at 6 a.m. It's going to be about $16,000. You guys will hear the jake brake in this truck too. It sounds really nice. Alright, we're backed up to the trailer. Alright, it's hooked up. The backup alarm is actually quite annoying, but whatever. So yeah, here's just a little glimpse of the cab. These cab overs look like they're a little bit wider than your typical like semi-truck. So here's a sleeper. Here's everything you really need. I really wish those lights weren't on inside here. I'm not entirely sure what year this truck is, but we are, I'm gonna go with like a late 70s, early 80s, somewhere around there. And we got about 676 miles to go, and let's just get this truck on the road. Like I said before, you guys will hear how awesome this truck sounds with the CAT engine and everything. Sounds really nice. Carson City to El Centro. It's going to be quite a trip. There's the jake brake. Sounds good as ever. I did add a mod into this game, and it was for obviously the cab over. I'll get into a little bit later on why I love cab overs. I really prefer cab overs over any other semi. But I did add the traffic mod, which I think was in last episode. Then I added lower fines as well. So like if I'm speeding, it won't be like $1,000 fine, it will be like a $300 fine. Alright, light's green, let's go. Let's head out of Kyle's Carson City, whatever. So we don't got too much weight, really, with the fertilizer, but it's enough. Looks like we've got a speed limit of 80 miles an hour coming out of here. And we should be good on fuel this entire trip. Alright, so it's down to 70 miles an hour now. Looks like these cab overs sit really high up in the air for what they actually are. I feel like I'm looking down on the road. Ooh, that's scary. Ooh, looks like we're gonna tip over there. Yeah, this cab engine shouldn't have an issue. We should be good. like Nitka have on this truck is there is no odometer, like in the speedometer, like it would be on a little truck like this, because you really want to have that computerized. I want to have that computerized digital on the left there. Just something that you want to have. So we're heading down basically almost to Mexico, because El Centro is pretty darn close. If you guys notice any lag throughout this, it's probably on my end. The program I've been using hasn't been doing its job really. Really don't get it. I can set it on cruise here. We should slow down for this train. Is that a cab over ahead of me? I can't tell. Alright, so on to the story on why I prefer cab overs. I don't really know how it started, really. I mean, obviously, I still love both style trucks. Like, I'll drive, you know, the W900 or whatever. But it's just, the cab overs, they just have, like, a unique look to them. It's an old-school, classic look. They don't make them anymore. I don't see many out, even, like, when I'm driving. There's hardly any, even on, like, the freeways or anything. And it's just something that I like. I just like the old-school style look on, especially older trucks. They look so cool. This truck's, you know, quite a bit older than your typical semi. It looks like I said, early 70s, late 80s, or late 70s, early 80s, geez, it was Lexic or something. I don't want to pass in the passing zone, but I kind of want to. Yeah, this Freightliner FLB is a beast of a truck, especially since I put the new engine in it. It just runs really nice. It's just that I just prefer their design and just like the uniqueness of them. It's by no means a new truck. Like, obviously it doesn't have any miles on it because the game, they're not going to put a million miles on it, because it wouldn't make it realistic if you just bought the truck new, you know? It's directional on for some reason. Okay, so it's two lanes here. He's coming back. I have to get in the right lane now. Yeah, this is pretty much episode 3. And it's just, I just love making these videos with American Truck Simulator. Especially since I modded, you know, the game to have the cab over in it. It just makes it all more fun. I got my favorite style truck. I probably prefer having like an international cab over, but you know, my Freightliners are just as nice, and you know, it's just as fun. I can't tell, that's a police officer behind me. So we are in Tonopah right now, just a small itty bitty town. Hey, we got our green light. Green means go. I really don't want to speed anymore because it's the fact I just don't want to keep throwing money at the police, you know? So we should arrive Thursday at 6 p.m. if everything goes well. Alright, so we should pick up here shortly. Can you just hear that turbo? There it is, 70. Lights on because nobody's coming. Now with the virtual reality, okay, I made a video the other day about it. Thursday. It's Sunday, right? Yeah, okay. And I give virtual reality, like, it's cool, it's a cool concept, don't get me wrong, but the only reason I would buy like the Oculus Rift, I don't even know if I'd buy the PlayStation VR. Unless like MLB the Show were to become available. But one of the only reasons I would honestly buy it is to play games like this, like American Truck Simulator, or just these simple, like, driving simulator games in general. Just because there's so much fun to play in virtual reality. Oh my gosh, that'd be so much fun. was honestly contemplating buying like a dev kit, but I don't know if those are any good or anything. Savings time, huh? That load we got on here is quite a big load. There's quite a bit of cars, some trucks going that way. Yeah, we should be fine on fuel. Ooh, it's 80 now, heck yeah. Let's kick this thing into overdrive. School bus out at 6 a.m. Holy cow, that's where they're going for kids for school. But they're on a freeway, so I don't know. Look at that sunrise. Look at that sunrise. Nah, I better slow down just a little bit. I'll go 66. Looks like we happen to have to make a right turn up here. Looks like it's going to be just a simple exit and turn right. I didn't notice I'm getting some frame rate dips. There's a bunch of cars on the screen. I don't know if it's just because the mod is not working. I don't know. It's, the more traffic, the merrier is what I like to think. Looks like we are. Ooh, I was gonna go. I'm going up to this red car, we got quite a bit of time. Here we are. We are off 30 miles an hour. Gotta make a left turn up here. I'm trying not to use those cheat mirrors, but this truck looks so wide. It's really hard to see in the mirror over there. Yeah, see, there's another thing. Virtual reality would come into play there. I don't know, guys. I'm on the fence still with VR. The only reason I'd honestly buy it is for like games like these, not for really sports games or anything. I mean, maybe. If they did it right. The whole thing I'm not sold on the PlayStation VR is because you have to use the Move controllers. I wish it was some kind of like a glove almost. Oh, if it was a glove thing, that would be way better. I didn't even think of that. Like, yeah, if it was like a glove so you could actually physically use your hands, that would be amazing. There's a fellow cab over friend. Greens go, green means go, green means go, green means go. Oh my gosh. Guys, green is go. We have a green light, but they have a green light? What? Alright, whatever. Whoa. Guys, coming in hot. school radio we have in here. That guy's turning on red. Okay, whoa, it is congested. This is too congested for me. Too congested for a big rigger. This will be fun trying to get over four lanes. Gotta get on the freeway here. Highway 15. So I like how the direction is even slower, because that's how they used to be back in the day. I'm talking like I'm 100 years old. Took that turn a little bit too sharp there. Almost nicked the trailer on the corner. Alright, we are off. Heading out of Vegas. Maybe not quite yet. What are we doing? Why are we stopping? I get asked from my friends a lot is, because they own PS4s and stuff, and they've never played this game, so when they come over, I'm like, dude, you gotta try, you know, American Truck Simulator. Well, at the time it was Euro Truck Simulator. And he sat down, put my 360 controller, played with that, and he pretty much fell in love with the game after that. And he's like, oh man, I wish it'd come out for a console. And I'm like, well, I don't think it ever will. Personally, I don't think it ever will, just because the market is not there for the game, and, you know, mods is what keeps this game fresh and, like, new. They make, like, if something doesn't look right with the game, you can just mod it, you know? I'm talking like I know how to do that. I really don't know how to do mods, but it just keeps the game fresh and, like, new. With console, you won't get that, and the graphics are going to take a huge hit. The map size is huge. Granted, the crew is online only, but I don't know if the map's going off their server or what. But the map is kind of low detailed. These maps that SCS does is pretty high detail for how big the map is in each state. I've got speed limit of 80. So yeah, long story short, I'd love to see it come to console. Would I want, like, would it be a good console port? Probably not. It wouldn't even look like that and feel like the same game. Plus, I think there's too many button combinations to do on a controller, to be honest with you guys. Like, I use my 360 controller, like, just for, like, the basic functions, but there's so many other things that you need to do on the game. Alright. Looks like we're leaving Prim. What are we doing? What on earth are we doing? Whoa, almost cut that guy off. I was going to change lanes, but apparently I'm not going to do that. Gosh, why is this traffic randomly stopping? Oh, we're coming into Prim now. Okay. looks like we shaved a couple hours off of our estimated time of arrival. That's cool. Smoked the side, but we did not damage. There's a tight exit there. Alright, looks like I gotta make a right turn up here. We're going 215 miles to go. Two cops, they're getting good. Two cops are at. Maybe they got a call. Who knows? They didn't have lights on though. But they don't have lights on in this game at all. This is getting a little longer. But I did see out there was a mod out there for it. It looks like it's overused. You know, fire trucks and ambulances. So I'll wait till they get the kinks worked out of it. Either those cops just disappeared, or they're going fast. Gotta cut that corner a little bit. I love that engine brake. It sounds so nice. I'm going 65 and a 40. It's not good. I just don't watch my speed apparently. I just cruise.
Ooh, this could be a tricked left turn here.
Oh, this is the worst time. It's almost lunchtime. And they are going. This highway is really busy. That's the kind of truck I originally wanted, was that Freightliner Classic. That is a beautiful truck. Look at that Audi. Alright. I don't think the AI really knows how this works. Oh, we're gonna be here quite a while, guys. What if I should just pull out? Nope. Holy cow, it's like lunchtime and this is the worst possible time I could have had to make a left turn onto a highway. I'm just gonna creep out a little bit. Oh, man. Gonna keep creeping because I'm not gonna get across unless I do this. Oh! Holy cow, I am so sorry. I am so sorry. I'd rather take that than not crossing the highway, to be honest with you guys. I usually don't do that, but that traffic was just too backed up for me to sit there and wait. We would have been there forever. Speed limit, 150 miles to go. wide open desert of in California. Now I didn't see anything specifically that said, oh, hey, California. Maybe I passed a sign and just didn't see it. Shoot. Gosh, I keep just holding down the right trigger. Takes away those old cars, because there is not that many cars in California. I've been there and there's not that many. Like, it's like 1950s. It's like now I realize with the mod it increases the traffic, so it's gonna add more of the same. But I'm sick of seeing that same car. Is it a Honda? Yes, it is. What just happened? I think it just stalled trying to go up the hill. Man, I let off the brake. Alright guys, while I was doing that, I just took a thumbnail photo. That was a pretty cool shot. I just stopped right there. We are back on the road. I held up traffic. Cool. Cool. Well, it's already 2 in the afternoon. Holy cow. Quarter after. About 87 miles out from the destination. Thinking like the game's like glitching out with the visor above, the sun visor. It's just the road. It's like reflecting. Yeah, a little ways to go here. Western Star? Or is that just a W900? Couldn't tell. Usually, like, truckers sleep in their truck. They don't stop at rest stops to sleep anymore. It's kind of like, well, they do, but then they sleep in their truck. So I hope there's a mod soon that will give that, have that be an option to sleep in your truck. Come on, look, there's a bed back there. You can crawl back there and go to sleep. Oh, hey, stay on the road. Looks like we are getting close to El Centro. wish like the radios weren't copyrighted. I could play some music, but can't do it. There is a Kenworth W900. There's a day cab. My GPS is really dark on the screen. I don't know why it's so dark. Looks like we gotta be making a left turn up here. Cars are just going willy-nilly. What are they doing? Oh, clear. They're going. Have fun, guys, with your traffic jam. Let's just take this turn a little bit wider. And we are approaching the destination. Needed some fertilizer delivered down here. Right, where do they want this thing? I'm gonna have to probably have to go over there and turn around, huh? Connect the thing over here. Looks like it's almost time to go home for everybody. It's 4 p.m. Let's just spin this thing around. It'll be a lot easier for me. Guy working on a thing. I don't know what that is. Let's get this thing straight out of the way. I have a clear shot of backing this thing up. This should be pretty simple. Should be two. I want to park it myself. Don't tell me. Oh, I just undercut it. And there we have it, guys. For the parking brick. And that is how you do it. Shut the truck off. Alright, guys, that's going to do it for this Let's Play. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And I will talk to you guys tomorrow. Have a good one.